All right, good evening, guys. Ken at Tortoise Capital Weekend Strategy Podcast for November 10th, 2023. Happy Veterans Day minus one. Start with the hybrid swing portfolio, 30-minute charts, beginning with Alcoa. This was a caught a two short from yesterday. We held it and covered it today for three. AI initiated a SSC midday. We're holding 1 hour overnight. Amazon SSC in the late morning, holding 2 hour. Caterpillar SSC late morning, was it was crossing the Bollinger Band mean standard risk. That's holding about 3 hour. Cliff. Yesterday's short we covered at the natural meeting of the Dragon and the PSAR for about 2 hour. Chevron. This was yesterday's exit where we ended up having a total of five positions on that over the last 3 days, and we got rid of three here. And we held the last two overnight, and they sold off, and then they didn't fail any further. And so as this was coming to the Dragon skin, we took the natural exit. That was just a massive trade, and it was so good that I missed the follow-on. Shame on me. Disney, this was a... I guess an afternoon hook. It wasn't quite the morning hook. By the time we entered, the run was done and basically scratched. Dish. Whoops. SSC, basically a scratch, didn't go anywhere. Devon. This is an emerging dragon. It sold off and then it stayed basically above the peak of the RL10, and so after that sold off and then started to recover, and it was north of the VWAP, and the Dragon was rising, and then the Owl was positive. You just hold your nose and buy it, and you take the exit here at the skin of the Dragon. That's about a half an hour. Electronic Arts, Kata 2 continuation, a third of an R. Emerging markets, this was excellent. So we got the SSC late morning and 2R at the close. ETHE initiated a gap and go, holding one. I really like that. If we look at the daily on this, this is really at the 250. I mean, this was a Godzilla way back here around 8, and we've been just beating it up all the way up, and it's now up to 17, looking pretty good. Mexico covered the short for 2R and then took the continuation SSC here, front running that a little bit by getting it as it crosses a Dragon, holding a little over 1 hour. Brazil, this one kind of shows why, you know, you sleep better at night when you're when you take them at the, don't hold the overnight risk. That was a 1 hour, that would have been a 2 hour loss, but we were able to get the PSAR flip and take home an R. Intel. initiated the Emerging Dragon and holding 1R over the weekend. IP took the half an R gift on the Collapsing Dragon. Real estate covered the short for two at the usual spot. Coca-Cola initiated a 1-2-3 entry. That one's holding with a nice run at the end of the day, 2R. Surprised. Regional banks got about 5R. We covered the short. It was just a single position all the way down, very relaxed. That feels like a local bottom put in right there. I'm expecting that to start looking pretty good next week. Yeah, I like that. I mean, there was a lot of buying pressure near that price level over here and ran it all the way up 10% up to 44. So I'm actually liking that one for next week. Mattel, short for half an R, the usual. Dragon exit. McDonald's, really like this one. Yesterday we closed near the at the close of the day we covered that one short, and then this morning it was a harsh gap down and reversal, and that feels like a 1-2-3 entry morning hook, and it really dominated for 2R. Merck covered the short in the usual spot late morning. There was just no failure in this market, so that was about 5R beauty. Microsoft Microsoft initiated the Emerging Dragon, standard risk, and 4R. That was good. Marijuana, 2R on an Emerging Dragon. Nvidia, 1R on a Kata 2. Clean Energy tried the short. It was the gap and go. Did not collapse, so we ended up scratching. Rivian, morning hook, 1-2-3 entry, no lose plus dinner for two, just didn't follow through. The S&P took the bait and they smashed it north. We talked about that as one of the two large move scenarios, and that was decisive all day, giving strength to everything that we trade. Treasuries, no trade. Tesla. I tried the short right out the gate because it gapped up and then started failing, and I front ran the collapsing dragon here, and then it reversed and took an R loss. Stopped and reversed, got about an R back, so probably net scratch. And U.S. Steel. I like this as part of the strength of the day, and it actually was grinding pretty nice. This is actually an improvement over that sideways quiet channel. That feels like a great big train carrying steel that broke the inertia at the wheels and is now trying to start to roll forward, and it closed very well. So I like that one. Good day at work. Sniper trade of the day. This is a 3-minute chart. This is CVS based on it was a target from yesterday's amazing trades. And yesterday it closed here. And this was the OR3 in blue. And the second bar, it dropped out of that like a rock. So we're short from here with a standard risk box. And nothing but red skies ahead. Checker hold. The first bar, out of the gate, and we should be at no lose plus dinner for two. I mean, it already gave us an R in the first bar, and that's the way we'd like it. Starting to stall. The R10 reverses. So that means we initiate the dragon skin exit, and we pick up plus one on one unit of risk, picking up one arm. Just getting started well. It rolls over. I take that as a cotta two. I front run that a little bit because it had gained so high and started to roll sharply. And I liked the way that first panic selling was going. So this is like a 1-2-3 short. And off we go. And it gives about a half an R. And I am noticing that higher low. So this failure was that large, this failure was only that large, and didn't go as low. So I take that as a positive. So I stop and reverse essentially as it crosses the VWAP. So that's a bit of a delay. That's about a 6 or 7 minute delay. I'm stalking it because here's the VWAP. And there's the Bollinger Band mean. So there's a little bit of confirmation there. So that was not a stop in reverse. That was just the stop. And then the reverse happened here. And here's the standard risk lining up with the belly of the RL10 and the PSAR. Checker hold. And 2 bars in, stop should be about there. And lock in that gain. Should have been out where I had the stop. And just sloppily gave back a scratch. Not my finest moment. Was not in a zero state, so I couldn't take that short. Recovered my sanity. And now, after lunch, stay out of the chop. And this is locking in that low. And this is about when the S&P just took off. So it crosses the Bollinger Band mean, crosses the VWAP. It moves a full risk box off the low. So I just take it. Check or hold. Now, if it can get above this, then my thought is it gets back, it can get back to here to the previous close. So this is a test right here. Can it get through? Yes, yes it can. So if, and our PSAR is just coming out of the risk zone. So because of the limit of the acceleration factor on this, which is 0.14, the PSAR can only accelerate to there. But you've got a price way up here because of those three accelerating bars. So that means this is a candidate to just lock in a gain somewhere. and then pick one of these lines to be your trailing stop. You could trail with the Pisar, you could trail with the Southern Skin of the Dragon, the Spine of the Dragon, the Upper Skin of the Dragon. So, you could also pick the Bollinger Band Main. We've got probably close to 2R in hand here. I like a 1-bar low on that one. And then probably the Upper Skin of the Dragon. That's a reasonable position to take. You know, a 2-bar low, if you're looking just to lock in a gain, right? You could say a 2-bar low, but that feels like it's given back that much. That feels like too much. So that's why, to me, the 1-bar low feels correct. Oops. Sorry about that. Sloppy mouse. So I think, as I look at that right there, like that, I should be out. And, again, bad form. I should be out there with 1.5 in hand, and then looking to re-enter. That's what I should be doing. So not a good exit. Got lucky. So what should have happened, what I should have done, is played this exit here, and then probably re-entered here. That's still not bad. Because I didn't exit there, I can now get a second entry there, but I would prefer the exit and then the quick re-entry. Wouldn't have costed anything. And so I get lucky by having held through that weakness. The only thing I can say is that the market and the sector were just on a tear right now and driving north strong. So maybe I had endorphins in my system. Just flat lucky. I better exit the second time. So a couple bad mistakes on that one. I thought that was poor. I liked the being able to pick that up and respond to that quadruple bottom and the crossing of the VWAP. That felt decisive. Plus, the market was good and just kept going. This was should have exited and then re-entered. So I didn't add a second position here or a third position because I already had two in. But if I had done this properly, I think it's exit, re-enter, and then second position, and then out here instead of there. Because I think I also stuck around too long here. And then I was so full, I missed the afternoon, that last little burst. But that's in the last half hour, so I'm not so bad. Traders. Brian continuing to crush it in the Kiwi. Gets paid for 0.94 and 31.5 R in 66 trades. Coming up on 0.4 rolling expectancy. Hamad. I'm going to say this again. There's your risk box. That's your noise. Here's your entry, as you did. One trade with plus one instead of minus 0.8. I mean, those two are, you're exiting in the noise. You know, a break of that low is the first price that you get that tells you it's failing this way. That's a reasonable re-entry. Reasonable short, a good cover. You're in the chop, but it's kind of working to your advantage. Quick exit. Might have improved a little bit. So this is pretty good through here. Yeah. Again, this one, if you just honor your stop and then pick up the PSAR, trade with smaller and smaller position size until you can just do that and stop exiting in the noise. This one gets paid. Good exit. Good patience to wait. Still kind of trading through the chop, but it didn't hurt you. You squeezed out a little here, I guess. That's pretty choppy. Rivian. Is that the OR3? Reasonable exit, good short. Got paid. I think this exit should be here because you got a break below the dragon instead of here. This is, you know, front running a collapsing dragon. When this leaves the dragon, I think you should be out here, and then that should be long instead of waiting for that. There were movers today to be found. We got to find them. All right, George, accountability is good. The second position. At reasonable. Got paid. Let's see. All right, gap and go. That's good. That's right by the numbers. Let's see. All right, so Ilker, let's. Apple, 3 minutes. OR3, got paid, that's good. Your short could be here when it hits the PSAR flip. That's still not bad. That should not be, I'm not sure why that's one of. You know, this is a case where the signal that this is failing is probably the top of the dragon. So if you get out here, that shouldn't be a minus one. That should be about a 0.6. That is not a kata two. That long that then fails here, that's not a kata 2. You don't have a higher you don't have a higher low from the RL10. So that's just an automatic stop and reverse, but without a pattern. And then when that doesn't go, don't take a full R loss. This is a... and now you're just chasing the trade because you're trying to make up for losses. Although this is a CD, this feels like you're just stopping and reversing automatically without seeing big successful moves, you know. This is a fine collapsing dragon. It's supposed to fail right away. When it doesn't, you got to get out at the edge of the dragon. Then you can be long here and then make that trade, and then your kata 2 should be here instead of here. Kata 2 there is pretty good. That's pretty good. If you looked at the S&P in this time frame, you would never take that short, because all the S&P was doing all day was this, with tech doing this, and there's no way, if you look at the market in the sector, that you want that short, especially watching this long freight train going north. And then this should be an entry long. OR3 short, covered. Yeah, this one reversed immediately. So if you take the full R loss, then you take the full R loss. All right. Got it all back. This short could be taken here on the PSAR flip. Then you get this. This is a good exit. Okay, you got out here, then went long and cut it. And again, I think you got to take that one. Then you did get the re-entry. This you exited just because you wanted to get a win. Re-entered here, you chased yourself out because you were reacting to the error and you felt like you got in late. Whereas if you just let that flow naturally, you should be getting out right about here. Kata 2 should be here. If you scratch and it doesn't fail, then you can get in sooner. And now you're kind of in the chop. But you netted almost 2. That's still pretty good. Pretty good shooting. Okay, Mexico. I'd probably take this as a kata 2 as you did. Good quick cut. I like the cut. Oh, you get short there. If you do, when these don't fail at all and they start moving up, then it's okay to get out. Good re-entry. You're just you're chasing the trade. You're automatically stopping and reversing without justification. That wouldn't cost you. Reasonable exit to preserve. I'd probably re-enter here. There's a kata 2 we got to hit. That's a good kata 2. Joe just showing off here a little bit. That's some pretty good shooting here. So he locks in. Let's see. The daily bars, okay. So he locks in 4 hour gain here, and then translated that market's money to options, plus 48R. Yeah, I mean, if we play this with our patterns, you get most of that in the first third of the time, and then a Kata 2 re-entry and get paid. And so you end up having to eat a lot of downtime. But still, you know, it's dead money, but it's an option, so it's not a huge cost to you, and it's market's money. And yeah, this looks like this test of the top side, that looks like it. I would not be surprised to see that really go now. What with the strength that we've had in the last 10 days and the fact that it was so powerful of a market close today, and tech was leading the way. So this could be pretty interesting. All right, weekend reports, November 11th. Bull normal. Strength has returned. Volatility favorable. The leading candidates are crushing it. ETF 2, the theoretical exposure gets marginally better to 30%. This is a favorable condition here. The fact that we got this nice little burst, and now 450 is in range. That's how amazing that last 10 days was. It went from disaster to taking out that previous resistance and closed very well today. So that actually feels pretty good. But you can see that the longer term market is coming to a test right here. The RL 270 is flatline. I said, is there really juice in here? But the 90, which rolled over, has come into the 6 o'clock position and wants to go like this. So if we get any kind of juice out of the 10, the 30 is already turned. That's going to drag the 90 north. And so 450 is the reasonable target for the test. That is really decisive. I'm not optimistic it gets through 450. And neither should you. I mean, that looks like a hard ceiling on it because it's had a couple runs at it. And this would still be an amazing... If it gets here and starts to hesitate, that's going to be such an amazing move that guys want to lock it in. You'll see selling pressure come in pretty hard. And there's still not a lot of good economic news or political news or social news that are out there to justify a return to all-time highs. So to me, 450 is a tactical ceiling here until proven otherwise. So I'm going to engineer it. Now, it doesn't mean it won't do it, and I'll be ready how would I play this? Oh, I know. Put some buy orders in here, like a little price ladder. Then expect it to fail. But if it doesn't, it'll burst through there, and then it hits trip wires, and then you get some buying positions, and you get surprised into that position. And it doesn't give you time to think about it. I mean, that works on a emerging dragon level from many different price points. So that's how I'm going to play it. The reversal this week in the 3 day was really strong. That's pretty good. And then the 9 day went from here to open and then all the way and break back north again. So this was a pretty good week. It's been a pretty good 10 days, actually. And it held at the Bollinger Band mean, just like it's supposed to. And the 9 day says, what are you even worried about? Follow the river. This breakout above the 30 looks promising. Today was a big range day up. And like we said yesterday, this could very easily get to 440. Because yesterday closed down here. We said, yeah, it could definitely get to 440. And sure is bigger than Stuttgart. There it was. Absolute strong directional move. Should not have been taking shorts today. When the market is doing that, you got to be able to see that. Let's see. The leaders continued to lead. Tech was just so dominant. That was all you needed to know this week. Brazil was pretty good, too. Inside the Dow, Apple. So should not have been short in that one. Today of all days. Microsoft crushing. Nothing much else to see here. Let's look at the liquidity. The symbols that are very liquid. Semiconductors. Biotech, regional banks, oil and gas, exploration, gold miners. Very, very liquid and very volatile. Yeah, we've seen those. Yep. Bullish normal. Strong market. The Dow 30, only two symbols on the auto framer because we're fully priced in. And real strength, Microsoft and NVIDIA. And strength in the diamonds, marijuana, NASDAQ and the S&P, and S&P tech. So very clear where the leadership is. Otherwise, standard stats here. Got a few symbols that are looking pretty good for early next week, like the metals at 2-1 and 3-1. Dish and Rivian have some room to gain. 6.5-1, 4-1. And good chance for clean energy and regional banks and real estate to all recover and start their cyclic reversal next week. Tail of the tape, dominating with tech names, no surprise. Defensive plays like gold and silver getting hammered. And that's everything we got, and we'll have the story, true story circle in the morning, and foundations and creativity Sunday morning. Take good care, and we shall see you soon.